Manipur is a beautiful state in the northeast of India, surrounded by hill ranges, and is rightly called the Jewel of India by Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. Manipur is also known as Kanglaipak or Sanalaipak to its inhabitants. It was one of the oldest princely states of India and is known for its rich cultural and ethnic diversity and history. In order to understand the evolution of the state of Manipur, we need to understand its geography.
Manipur has two distinct geographical regions. One is the plain area, the valley, which is relatively small. 1/10 of the entire area of the state in the valley, and the rest, 90%, is in the hills. And what happens usually in such a situation is that you have a valley where agriculture grows, and that actually makes the economy of the place much stronger than in the hills.
Manipur is home to a number of ethnic groups who live harmoniously following different religious faiths. Sanamahi is the indigenous religion of the state. In the early 18th century, King Pamhaiba, also called Garib Niwaj, adopted Hinduism and made it the state's religion. King Bhagyachandra, grandson of Pamhaiba, founded the Sri Sri Govindaji Temple.
In Bengal, there was a bhakti movement that was happening. This is the Hindu missionaries, Hindu message of peace and harmony and love was being spread in Bengal, the Bhakti movement, and contrasted this with what was happening on the Burmese side. There was always war. So the king at the time, initially a very great warrior, his name is Pamhaiba, he decided that Manipur's salvation probably will be in this Bhakti movement. So he adopted Hinduism. And the valley region actually became Hindus because of him. He was the first to convert, and then he also made it a state religion. So Manipur became Hindu in the early 18th century.
Most Manipuris are followers of Vaishnav Hinduism. The Sri Sri Govindaji Temple is a sacred center for the Vaishnavites. It is a simple and beautiful structure with twin gold domes, a paved courtyard, and a large congregation hall. The presiding deity, Radha Govinda, is flanked by idols of Balram and Krishna on the one side and Jagannath, Balbhadra, and Subhadra on the other.
Ngasi ngasi bauda lepalai tana Sri Sri Radha Govinda amadi Ram Krishna amadi Jagannath Balabhadra Subhadra thong ahum sigi ngasi bauda aing asa nungsa aing ba ulen punamak thadu oga ngasi bauda Sri Sri Raja Sri Bhagachanda Maharaj haktak tagina ngasi bauda arya palai tana Sri Sri Govinda gi seva astakal gi seva si ngasi bauda adumak taunari.
Even after adopting Hinduism, the traditional Sanamahi faith continued in Manipur. The religion entails worship of Sanamahi, the ancestral deity, nature and natural phenomena. All Maitei households have a place in their homes reserved for Sanamahi and other deities such as goddess Laimaren.
Lining thau Sanamahi Manipur ke Mitei jati jo parampara se abhi tak ho rahi hai inke Parmeshwar ka naam hai aur prarambh mein iska nirakar roop ki puja ki jati thi lekin 16vi shatabdi mein jab raja Kiamba ka kaal tha tab se iska ek murti ban gayi aur usi murti ko puja karne lage aur dheere dheere phir इसी को 18वीं सदी में जब राजा पामहिब का शासन था तब इसको फिर जो जब वहां से हिंदू धर्म का प्रभाव पड़ा था तब से उस मूर्ति को तोड़ दिया और पुनः उनका निर्माण किया तब से अभी तक ये जो एक मूर्ति के रूप में यहां खड़ी रही है और फिर यही जो धर्म इससे संबंधित है इसी Dharma ka naam Sanamahi Dharma hi rakha hai.
There is another important deity, Pakhangba, represented by a serpent with its tail in the mouth, signifying, in the end is the beginning, and in the beginning is the end. Christianity is the other main religious faith which is followed by a sizable tribal population of the state. Christians visit the churches regularly and participate with zeal and enthusiasm in church activities. Muslims who came into Manipur in the 18th century, along with the enemies of kings from Kachar areas of Assam, are known as Maitei Pangals. Maitei Pangals are mainly settled in the valley areas of Manipur.
Manipuri Muslims, known as Maitei Pangal, came to Manipur during the reign of King Khagemba in the year 1606. Before that, Muslim also came and settled here in Manipur. These Muslims, we are given land and Maitei ladies. They were rehabilitated in Manipur. So actually Muslims were influenced by the cultures of Manipuri Maiteis. So at the beginning, you see, as a result of Maitei ladies, these children born out of this wedlock between Muslims and the Maiteis, the Muslims were influenced culturally, economically, very much by the Maiteis. So for about 400-500 years, Muslims were completely influenced by the Maiteis.
यहाँ हम लोग मुसलमान है 8 or 9% के बीच में तो हम लोग पालन करते हैं साल भर में दो बार ईद उल फितर और ईद उल अजहा ये दोनों ईद जो है हम लोग पालन करते हैं यहाँ बाकायदा और यहाँ हम लोग मेजर कम्युनिटी हिंदूज के साथ हम लोग रहते हैं और ट्राइबल्स जो ईसाई जिसको कहा जाता है उनके साथ हम लोग रहते हैं यहाँ सिख ईसाई सब कुछ है लेकिन मणिपुर में ख़ास तौर पर जात पात और धर्म के लिहाज से कोई तनाव और कोई झगड़ा अब तक नहीं है
कांगला is the most important historical and archaeological site in the state. It is the cradle of the evolution of culture and tradition in Manipur.
As a student of history, I always regarded this place, Kangla, as a very, very important part of Manipur. At the same time, it is closely associated with the civilization of this place. And Kangla is the ancient capital of Manipur because it is closely associated with the cosmological era of Manipur. So therefore, each and every people of Manipur, they consider Kangla is the cradle of the human civilization of Manipur. Before 33 AD, because 33 AD is a very important landmark in the entire history of Manipur, because from this period, you know, a new political environment was developed just after the leadership of one historical personality. His name was Nongda Laren Pakhangba, and he started a new dynasty that we call it Dinthoja dynasty in 33 AD. Kangla was treated as a seat of power. At the same time, you know, to the religious people, this Kangla is regarded as one of the most important religious sacred place. And the point is this, before the coming of Nongda Laren Pakhangba, it is the center of power of one Khaba group and like this. Look, why Kangla is so important? The reason was that because right from the very, very early stage, a large number of different ethnic groups of peoples, they have migrated from the different areas. And this place, now we call it Manipur, at that time it was not Manipur, but this place was the meeting place for all the peoples coming from the different directions. Under the leadership of Nongda dynasty, then the importance of Kangla was gradually developed. And then finally, in the whole infrastructure of Kangla, you know, began to renovate during the time of the different rulers, particularly Khagemba's period.
Kangla is situated in the center of the city of Imphal, which is 2,619 feet above the sea level. Kangla is now a citadel, surrounded on all sides by deep moats that were built to resist attacks. The royal palace in Kangla was destroyed by the British after the occupation of Kangla. Today, it is a vast place with remains of a few heritage buildings and the ancestral place of the royal family, areas of worship and shrines. The outer western gate or entrance of the palace is a traditional structure. Pakhangba Temple, which was inside the Kangla, was demolished by the British. It has been newly constructed again. Kangla Shah, or the dragons, as the symbol of royal power, stand on either side of the steps leading to Uttra, the royal house. These are reported to have been constructed originally in 1804 AD. And reconstructed by Maharaja Chandrakirti in 1873. But these were destroyed by the Burmese and the British during their subsequent occupation of Kangla. Near the Kangla Shah, there was also a large Uttra Shangai or hall constructed first in 1629 AD during the reign of King Khagemba.
Khagemba began to develop the Kangla area. Then he had some kind of a relationship with the Chinese, and through Chinese now, then the Manipur people was able to get the knowledge of how to construct the brick making, or rather how to make the bricks. So this type of a technology was received from China. Then after this, now Khagemba began to construct the wall by brick. Then citadel by brick. So from the time of Khagemba, then Kangla's, you know, the physical features of the Kangla began to develop in a modernized way.
This building was destroyed in the Second World War. Its brick steps are the only remains of the old structure. Kangla Shah statues were reconstructed in 2007. Remains of the citadel, the residence of Maharaja of Manipur, is inside Kangla. It also had arsenal inside the citadel, where arms and ammunition were kept. Thank you. The Sri Sri Govindaji Temple is the original shrine of Manipuri Vaishnav kings. After the conquest of Manipur in 1891, the British destroyed the temple. Its remains have been recently renovated. Hiang Tanaba, or boat race, used to be one of the most important royal rituals of the palace. The royal boat, or Hiang, is mounted with the head of a deer, and the tail is mounted with a human skull. A model is now preserved at Kangla. The Nupi Lan, which means women's war, was fought against the British by the women of Manipur and is well known in the history of Manipur. The two Nupi Lans were revolts against the British administration for enforcing lalup, or forced labor, on Manipuri men, and export of rice from the state during famine. Women protested and razed the state bungalow of the British agent and set the market stalls in Khairamban Bazaar ablaze. The Nupi Lan Memorial celebrates the two events in Manipur history.
The outbreak of women's agitation, locally we call it Nupi Lan, the outbreak of women's agitations, it is a very, very important and a significant, you know, event in the entire history of Manipur. There was two women's agitations that we call it Nupi Lan. One was in 1904, another one in 1939.
Kuki Uprising also forms an important part of the history of Manipur. It was a result of excessive interference of the British political agents in administration of hills, in form of introduction of compulsory house tax on every household, irrespective of their status, and pothang, a compulsory form of labor, on all villagers by turn. All these led to a general uprising amongst the Kukis, also known as the Kuki Rebellion.
Earlier what happened, the chiefs were enjoying their rights, but with the coming of British, what happened, their rights have been infringed. So this is the sole responsible factor for the cause of Kuki Rebellion. Two most important economic causes were the collection of house tax and pothang. Pothang means those forced laborers.
The Battle of Khongjom in April 1891 represents the most decisive battle fought between Manipur and the British before the British occupied Kangla. After the Treaty of Yandabu, signed between Manipur, Burma and the British in 1826, the British began to openly interfere in the political affairs of Manipur. This culminated in the Manipur Rebellion of 1891, when three British officers were killed in a conflict. This resulted into open warfare and seizure of the Manipur throne by the British and its annexation into British India. Khongjom battle was fought 30 kilometers away from Imphal in the present-day Thoubal district. The Anglo-Manipur War of 1891 was a watershed in the history of Manipur. The rebellion of Jubraj of Manipur and his army was put down, resulting in the execution of Bir Trikendrajit and Thangal General at Paidapung, near the present polo ground, by hanging them in public. In the memory of the indomitable spirit of these martyrs, Bir Trikendrajit Park has been erected at Imphal. Rani Gaidinliu, a Kabui Naga woman, was a well-known freedom fighter. She joined the movement launched by Jadunang, a Naga leader, from the Tamenglong district of Manipur against the British at the age of 13.
Rani Gaidinliu was born In 1915, at a village called Longkao in Tausem subdivision of Tamenglong district, Manipur. She is the only lady who participated in Indian freedom movement, the only tribal ladies during the independent movement in India. Rani Gaideliu was a spiritual and political leader of the Jelengrong community. Jelengrong community consists of Jemai, Liangmai, Rongmai, who inhabited the tri-junction of Assam, Nagaland, and Manipur. This Jelengrong community has a very good leader in the name of Jadonang. Jadonang revolted against the British because of the forced labor as well as the hill house tax imposed on the people. Jadonang was accordingly arrested, and after a mock trial, he was hanged here at Imphal in 1931. The leadership thereafter was taken over by Rani Gaideliu, and she promoted the ideal propagated by Jadonang and fought against the British. She was arrested in 1932 and was imprisoned for life. Jawaharlal Nehru met Rani Gaideliu in 1937 in Tura jail in Meghalaya, and he was so impressed by this young girl who fought for the freedom of India. Nehru tried his best to get her released from the jail, but the British government thought that if she is released, she will start the movement again. So the request for the release by one British MP, Ashley, was rejected by British Raj in India. She got released from the jail after independence in 1947, and Jawaharlal Nehru, after meeting her in Tura jail, was given her the title Rani Gaideliu. Government of India has given a recognition in terms of giving her Tamrapatra Award for the freedom fighter in 1972, then Padma Bhushan in 1982, then the commemoration of stamp in her name was released, and also during her birth centenary, Government of India has released a commemorative 100 rupees coins and 5 rupees coin. 5 rupees coin is for circulation, whereas 100 rupees coin was for a commemorative thing.
The Imphal War Cemetery is constructed and maintained by the Commonwealth War Graves Commission. It is made for the soldiers of the British and the Indian Army who sacrificed their lives during World War II. There are rows of little markers and bronze plaques recording their names and brief accounts of their sacrifices. INA War Memorial. Manipur has been the principal overland route for trade between India and Myanmar since olden times. During the World War II, it was also the arena of three fierce battles between the Japanese and the Allied forces. The Indian National Army, led by Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose, entered Manipur and touched the Indian soil during the Second World War for the first time at Moirang. Netaji hoisted the national flag at Moirang on 14th April 1944. The Indian National Army War Memorial has been built at Moirang.
This is INA War Memorial Complex. During the Second World War, Moirang was made the headquarters of INA, and the INA soldiers have stayed here in Moirang for 3 months at the INA headquarters, 1 kilometer away from this museum. And the first tricolor flag of INA was first hoisted here on 14 April 1944 at this complex by Colonel Sokot Ali Malik of Bahadur Group of INA. Since then, this place has been a very special place in the history of the INA movement. And this museum was established in 1969 as was inaugurated by the then Prime Minister Srimati Indira Gandhi.
There was a fierce battle during the Second World War in Maibam Lotpaching in Bishnupur district. It was a battle between the Japanese forces supported by the Indian National Army and the British forces supported by the Manipur King, Maharaja Bodhrachandra. The battle lasted for 9 days. The Japanese forces suffered a heavy defeat and almost all Japanese soldiers were killed. The battle was the crucial turning point in the Second World War and reversed the advance of Japan into India. The India Peace Memorial was built in 1994 by the Japanese government to commemorate the 50th anniversary of the Battle of Manipur, dedicated to Japanese troops who lost their lives. The memorial consists of concrete walls, red sandstone floors, and 3 large uncut sandstones. Near the India Peace Memorial, there is one more memorial with a traditional structure which was built in 1977 with inscriptions in Japanese. With such a checkered history and rich cultural heritage, Manipur offers a window to the history of the formal princely kingdom located in remote corner of the country. Manipur's link with India's freedom movement makes its history very significant.